Most merciful and loving God, we give you thanks and praise for all your many gifts to us. We thank you especially for the gift of bread. We are saddened because we're going to miss him dearly, but the many ways in which he has touched our lives will give us hope and assurance of your love for us, of his love for us. We ask you now to enwrap him in your ever-loving embrace for all eternity, and also embrace each one of us as we grieve for his loss, but with true hope and faith that we will be reunited with our beloved husband, our dad, our granddad, our friend. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Now, if you just meet me over by the baptismal font. Let us begin our prayer in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. In the waters of baptism, Fred died with Christ and rose with him to newness of life. May he now share with him eternal glory. In his baptism, he received a white garment as a sign of his purity in Christ. We now place that white garment on his casket, which has grown with him through this life and now accompanies him to eternal life. Fred lived to the best of his ability the gospel in his life. May he now receive what it promises. He knew that that gospel required an embrace of God's cross of love and sacrifice for those that God placed in his life. May he now be embraced in God's eternal love. Let us take our brother to the altar of the Lord.
I the Lord see and scour.
Let us pray. O God, in whom sinners find mercy and saints find joy, we pray to you for our brother Fred, whose body we honor with Christian burial, that he may be delivered from the bonds of death. Admit him to the joyful company of your saints and raise him on the last day to rejoice in your presence forever. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated to hear the word of God.
A reading from the book of Sirach. Children, pay heed to a father's right. Do so that you may live. For the Lord sets a father in honor over his children. A mother's authority he confirms over her sons. He who honors his father is gladdened by children, and when he prays, he is heard. He who reveres his father will live a long life. He who fears the Lord honors his father and serves his parents as rulers. In word and deed, honor your father, that his blessing may come upon you. For a father's blessing gives a family firm roots. Glory not in your father's shame, for his shame is no glory to you. His father's honor is a man's glory. My son, take care of your father when he is old. Grieve him not as long as he lives. Even if his mind fail, be considerate with him. Revile him not in the fullness of your strength. For kindness to a father will not be forgotten. It will serve as a sin offering. It will take lasting root. In time of tribulation, it will be recalled to your advantage. Like warmth upon frost, it will melt away your sins. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. We know that the one who raised the Lord Jesus will also raise us with Jesus and place us with you in his presence. Everything indeed is for you, so that the grace bestowed in abundance on more and more people may cause the thanksgiving to overflow for the glory of God. Therefore, we are not discouraged. Rather, although our inner self, our outer self, is wasting away, our inner self is being renewed
day by day. For this momentary light affliction is producing for us an eternal weight of glory beyond all comparison. As we look not to what is seen, but to what is unseen. For what is seen is transitory, but what is unseen is eternal. For we know that if our earthly dwelling, a tent, should be destroyed, we have a building from God, a dwelling not made with hands, eternal in heaven. The word of the Lord.
Sisters and brothers, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God, have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way." Thomas said to him, "Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. I think Freddie would have gotten a kick with us sitting down and standing up again, just saying. Before I begin my reflection, I would ask the favor of your blessing.
May the blessing of the Lord be upon you. We bless you in the name of the Lord.
Freddie's been doing that for me since I got here, so I figured we had to do that one more time. We come to this farewell of a sort. And yet, we hold in our hearts the fullness of who Freddie is. No? And that gospel reading in particular, preparing a place for us. He was all his life preparing places, no? And I truly believe that all of the many people he was so loved by those that he built things for, not because that of the craftsmanship that he did, which was wonderful, but because he saw in everyone a family member. And many of those people became close friends, no? Same thing here at the church. Everybody was loved by Fred, and everybody loved him. That first reading, you guys lived very inspiringly. I think you inspired our whole church about how well he loved him and took care of him. It broke all our hearts as we slowly lost him over many years. But I will always remember the brilliant smile that he always had, the corny jokes. I mean, if he told me once, he told me 100,000 times that a wife's faults are many, but a husband's are only two. Everything we say and everything we do. That was Fred, no? He always had a gleam in his eye because he always had some funny thing to say. He had a quick wit, and he loved to be with people. I think he loved celebrations. The Irish celebrations were one with the Blarney brothers, and I think it was a couple of years ago. That we couldn't have the big Irish celebration, but for his birthday, we had a sing-along there at the house because he so loved being able to celebrate and sing those wonderful songs with everybody. And he just was a kind and loving presence, you know. And I think it was a competition after any gathering or mass or wherever it was, who could talk to more people, him or Joyce, because neither one of them were waiting for each other because they were always talking to somebody, and they were always the last to leave because there was nobody left to talk to. But that's just the openness of heart that Freddie had for everyone. He just saw everyone as a brother or a sister, as a niece or a nephew, a daughter, a son, a grandson, a granddaughter. He just treated everyone with that same love, care, and concern. No? And he loved his country. He served his country faithfully. did everything to the best of his ability, whether it was at Bendix for many years in fabricating and making the machines and fixing the machines and doing anything that needed to happen to rebuilding kitchens and bathrooms and in office buildings and whatever needed to be done, he was there. I kept thinking of our kitchen because it's kind of falling apart like Freddie was. But he was the one that was instrumental in putting it all together back 30 years ago, who knows, many years ago, how many ever it was, 20 years ago. That was just Fred. He was always there to lend a helping hand wherever anybody needed it. So we need to listen to that second reading, that we need not be discouraged. Yes, we saw his outer shell wasting away for several years, but even when I came and prayed with you guys, he still had that gleam in his eye, even though he couldn't communicate in the ways that he did for most of his life, he still was Freddy inside. And I mean, that was part of the tragedy, is couldn't express himself like he used to. But we know now that he is restored. He is the fullness and even more than the fullness of what he was when he was with us. No? And he's in the embrace of our loving God. And he still is in love and care for each of us. The thing is, you can't hide anything from him anymore. He sees everything because he's with Jesus. No? And he will come back to you in many different ways. The next time that you just take a little road trip, not sure exactly, well, you kind of know where you're going, but you end up somewhere else. The next time that you have a project and you're not sure exactly how to do it, he'll be there inspiring you, saying, no, not that tool, the other one. The next time that you have a party, he'll be there with his funny hat. He loved the different hats that you put on him. And there's two things that we need to remember when he comes back to us. One is that you're not going crazy and it's not a ghost. I mean, that's what the apostles thought when he came back in his resurrection. He had to show them the wounds in his hand and his side. He asked them for something to eat that he might proclaim to them that he is alive and well, he's still with us. And being embraced with God, united with God, Freddie is still with us too. We know that from Matthew's gospel. No, when Jesus went up to heaven, he said, I will remain with you until the end of time. And so the second thing we need to remember is when we have those encounters with those that we have loved, we're afraid to share them. We're afraid to share the memories because we're afraid that it will bring sorrow at the separation. But my friends, when Freddie comes to you, he'll come in the love of God and the very Holy Spirit, which is the Spirit of God's love that calls us to reach out one to the other. And so we need to continue to walk with one another. What a great testimony that even in the middle of COVID, we've got as many people as we can fit safely in the church to honor our beloved Freddie and also to support his loved ones, Joyce and Debbie and Patty and Sean and everybody else that loved him so. My friends, our support cannot stop today. We need to continue to reach out in love and care, especially Joyce and the girls and Sean. They need our help. They need our support. And they're going to come to mind going forward next week, next month, 3 months from now. They'll come to mind. Don't just blow that off. We have a tendency to do that, don't we? somebody will pop into our mind, and okay, well, maybe I should call that person, maybe I should, and then we get on with our day. I would encourage you to know that that's the Holy Spirit, that in that very moment when somebody comes to mind, if Joycey or Debbie or Patty or Sean come to mind, they need you in that moment to pray for them. And it only takes a moment. My mom would describe them as arrow prayers. It's just a phrase or two, you know. Oh, my goodness, Joyce just came to mind. God bless her, be with her. Whatever she needs in this moment, supply it, please. How long did that take? Less than half a minute, right? But there's one more thing you need to do, too. Not just, yes, the prayer is essential, but how do you know? How do they know that you're praying for them? If you don't take another half a moment, maybe for those of us that have a little gray hair, maybe it's a little bit more than half a moment. But most of us have phones that text, no? And to just text a little something, you know? You came to mind, I'm praying for you. Just those little tiny expressions, my friend, are enough to sustain us on a difficult day, at a difficult moment. We need to reach out, no? Make a phone call. God forbid if you should take some time to actually write something with your own hand and not just text. Because there's something about receiving something at the mailbox that's still very powerful. Joycey still does it. When I went over to their house to talk about the readings and whatnot, Joycey had two huge bags of stamps that she had taken off the envelopes and things for people that have sent stuff to them that she sends out to other people. She's a wonderful example of keeping in contact through cards and notes and those things. I encourage you to take the time to be for one another in those little things. It's St. Teresa's little way to heaven. And Fred did it very, very well, too. And just the little smile and the little conversation, the word of comfort, the corny joke, whatever it takes to brighten somebody's day, to brighten somebody's moment, is the little way of showing God's love and care for them. There you go. That's the... And that's okay, because by the end of the conversation, it was no longer a wrong number, it was a new friend. Right? We need, and both Joyce and Fred have lived this for almost 60 years together, even more because you were courted for quite a while before you got married, is just seeing not strangers, but potential new friends. Now, even the time that you had in Germany, it was only a short 2 years, but you left there with a whole new family but not just Debbie. I'm talking about all the people that you invited into your family, and you still are in contact with people, and some of them are here even, you know, that you met and came to know in Germany. My friends, we need to, that's the perspective of Christ. That's a Christ-like life, is to see not strangers, but friends in everyone that we meet. And that blesses a home, blesses a family, blesses our lives. And we need to keep that attitude of friendship that Freddie so well taught us. As we go forward, because God doesn't want to just save you. He wants to save us all together as the family of Christ. And so let us live the legacy of friendship that Freddie gave us and continues to call out of us, so that we too might not just glory in the reunion that we'll have in the big Irish sing-along in the sky, but that we might also live it and have it every day that we walk together. With the laughter and the tears, it's all a part of a life lived well in Christ. Amen. Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church, confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus. We join our prayers to his.
In baptism, Fred received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead him over the waters of death. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Our brother Fred was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome into the halls of heavenly banquet. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the family and the friends of our brother Fred, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord who wept at the death of his friend Lazarus. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our deceased relatives and friends, and for all who have helped us, that they may have the reward of their goodness. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us assembled here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer Jesus Christ and the voices of your people whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ and grant them a place in your heavenly kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen.
Standing always at my side. I climb to the heavens, you are there. If I fly to the sunrise or sail beyond the sea, still I find you
Brothers and sisters, that this my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Fred, we beseech your mercy, that he who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying may be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Indeed, holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, By that same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for the many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this living and holy sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victims by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Francis and St. Maximilian, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Alan, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people that you have gained for your own.
Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned here before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Fred, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Form us by your word and graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will. You live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God.
Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be. Let us accompany those who are participating from home to receive spiritually Jesus in this prayer for spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you in my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and I unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. For those that are visiting, because of COVID, we do one line at a time. So this side will go first. There's little marks, little stars to guide your way, just like the Magi. So you can keep the six foot distancing. Wait until you get up to the front to lower your mask to receive communion, and then put it back up after you're done. Body of Christ.
All who drink shall live.
Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body and blood food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our brother Fred may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Fred, and now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Freddy again and enjoy his friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joys of his heavenly kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another with the faith and love of Jesus Christ. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother Fred in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Fred in this life and the many blessings that you bestowed on each one of us through him in this life. They are all signs of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant Fred, and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith, hope, and love until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our brother forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
Bow down for the blessing. Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the sorrowful, and you are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people who cry out in their need and strengthen their hope in your lasting goodness and love. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. May Fred rest in peace.
Amen.
Amen. And may his soul and the souls of all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace.
Amen. Amen.
And may the peace of God, which is beyond all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and in his Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. May Almighty God bless us, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. Joyce, did you want to say a word or two? Do we have the cookies? Or
yes.
We do have the cookies.
Love you, Joyce.
She'll keep us here for another half an hour, so we need to move on. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord and our brothers and sisters, just as Fred did.
Thanks be to God.
I will give. Blessed.